that we call it 418 cortado. Cortado also is another expression related to tango, means chop, cut. So 8 cortado, because the following movement, instead of flowing like, let's say, an 8, here is more chopping, more staccato. So after this movement is where we are going to add the 418. So we still, we have for the follower, the 8 cortado, but in the exit, we will make a 418. So again, for the follower, here, and the 418 to exit. One more time, the follower, the 8 cortado, and here, 418 to exit. And the exit will be the side step that we did around the chair, same as we did around the chair. One more time. 8 cortado, and 418, and here is a side step around the chair. So maybe from that point of view, not so clear to see, but see, I am pivoting and this foot will go to the side. The leader, bring your partner to the right. Here is where you make her change weight, and that's how we are going to make her come back with the 418. And here, leaders, we will change the foot that moves forward. It will be our right together with the follower's left moving forward. Again, the leader brings the follower to the right, make her change weight. Lead her a 418, lead her another 418, and step together with her left going that direction with your right. Her left, your right. One more time. This element is the 8 cortado, 418 cortado. And now to bring her into the 418. This 418. She steps, I pull my feet together. I am making her go forward there with her left. My right goes together with her. And then she will step around us, but we will see what the leader does after. We've been working in the previous class. One more time. Here. 418, 418. This is what we did last class to make a sacada. If the sacada is not there, no problem. If you arrive to both the leader stepping forward here with his right and the follower stepping forward with his left, after the 418, that's good. Then bring your partner in front of you.